I want to throw something at you. Now, I think what separates, in my opinion, Skid Row from many other late 80s hard rock bands is that punk influence. And from a fan's perspective who possibly analyzes things too much, I reckon if you and Rachel wrote a couple of songs with a guy like Mike Ness from Social Distortion, the results, you know, could be amazing. Is that wishful thinking on my part? Has anyone ever thrown that idea at you before?
Well, I mean, no one's ever thrown that idea. That would be an honor. I have great respect for Mike Ness. And, you know, the punk influence band, truth be told, comes from Rachel. And it's interesting. We you know, we didn't grow up together. We met each other when we were in our early 20s and but got to know each other really fast. We hit it off amazingly. And so we just started hanging out and you know, started writing songs together. That was the basis of this band, was built around Rachel and I writing songs together. And, you know, you have these conversations, you're riding around in your car, you're listening to different records and stuff like that. And we found, you know, we had common ground in, you know, Kiss and Aerosmith and Judas Priest and Cheap Trick and Nugent and stuff like that. And then, but he was into a lot of the original punk rock, you know, the Ramones, the Sex Pistols, the Tough Darts, the Damned, the Clash. And where I grew up, we were very familiar with, you know, especially the Ramones. I mean, you know, I was 45 minutes out of New York City, and CBGB's was legendary as a kid. And, but I tended to lean more towards new metal when that started filtering into the United States. And a lot of those bands, you know, the Iron Maiden, Tigers of Pentang, Samson, and all those bands. So I started more towards there. He was leaning more towards the Pistols and the Ramones and whatnot. So when we got together, he sort of ignited my fuse, if you will, with regard to those bands. And reintroduced me to them, and thus he had much more of that influence in him than say I did. So that's what he would bring, part of what he would bring to the table when we would sit down, and part of what I would bring would be that not the opposite, but that heavy metal portion of our writing, if you will. So he brought the Ramones in and I brought Iron Maiden in, and somehow we met somewhere in the middle of where Kiss and Aerosmith and lie.
It's a good
to be able to sit down and you know, write with a person like Mike Ness would be amazing. I mean, you know, I wish that we had the opportunity to, you know, when we were younger to write with the Ramones, you know, doing psychotherapy on Beside Ourselves was amazing, but to have him in the video, Joey Ramone in the video, was just an absolute honor, and to be recognized and acknowledged by those guys was just over the top. One of those things where you wish for as a kid, but you don't really think it's ever going to happen. So I kind of went away from the original question, but
That's fine. And a spin-off for that is, I've always wondered how the band would sound if, say, Ed Stasium or Daniel Ray or somebody who worked with the Ramones, what they could do with Skid Row.
I've known Daniel Ray for, gosh, I first met Daniel Ray before Skid Row started. Before he was a friend of mine. He was a friend of a friend of mine who was A&R person for Elektra Records, Michael Alago. And so I met Daniel through Michael Alago. And he was just the sweetest guy. And unbeknownst to me, I had, when I was a youngster, going to different clubs in New York and New Jersey, I saw Daniel Ray's band that he was the guitar player in play at the Fastlane in Asbury Park when I was like 15 years old. I had no idea. And it's weird how these roads, you know, collide, these paths collide. And you know, Daniel had a great deal to do with cementing the legacy of the Ramones, I think. Obviously, he's played a big part in whom they were as an entity. And so to write with Daniel Ray, it's funny. I would love to put, you know, simply said, it would be an honor, of course. And say Ed Stasium too. I mean, my gosh, what an amazing producer.